Now, Storm Tracker weather with East Idaho's chief meteorologist, Doug Iverson.
Tracking thunderstorms right now. Our neighbors up to the north getting some storm activity. You can see it on the radar map. Showers and strong thunderstorms. One just to the north of West Yellowstone, not too far from Henry's Lake, which is located right about there. You just go north of the border, it's a different story. A little storm just off towards the west could actually hit Henry's Lake and maybe even as far south as Island Park, and a strong thunderstorm around Lenoir. So most of the activity, northern tier of East Idaho, and the brunt of it, as you can see, into Big Sky country. Some moisture trying to dribble in from the south. Some monsoonal moisture, yeah, working its way up. That's typical this time of year. We get not only the heat, but we get some moisture that creeps in all the way in from Mexico, and that heat with that moisture creates a little firework activity as far as Mother Nature's concerned, and we could see more showers and thunderstorms pop up, not just to the north and to the south, but right in the middle of East Idaho as early as tomorrow afternoon. Right now, it's just heat. We're at 94 at Pocatello, Idaho Falls hot 92. Look at Salt Lake City, 101. I will say this, we don't have to worry about any of that heat, but my goodness, yeah, they could have that, right? And they could see some thunderstorms as well here in the next little bit. Even this evening, we have a few showers trying to pop up over the Salt Lake Valley. Mostly clear tonight, no showers, no thunderstorms. Here you get just north of St. Anthony, perhaps a different story, and a mild one out there. Pocatello 62, American Falls 58. Very isolated rain showers and thunderstorms to the central mountains. Most of it concentrated off towards the east, southeast, so around Lenoir. Lenoir tonight, we'll see a low of 54 along with Salmon. Very isolated showers and thunderstorms this evening for the upper highlands and western Wyoming. Most of it concentrated from around Island Park on north and east into Yellowstone National Park. Mostly clear tonight for the southeast corner of the state. Low temperatures will drop all the way down in the upper 40s in Montpelier to almost 60 for Loma Ladd City. We certainly have another hot day tomorrow. Maybe a few more clouds popping up in the sky, especially later in the day. 94 in Ladd City, 92 in Lava Hot Springs. For the upper highlands, we could see showers and thunderstorms pop up all over the place, especially tomorrow evening. That's when the best chances of seeing storm activity will be. Tomorrow for the central mountains, same thing. We still have a few of us enduring those 90s. It is summer, right, after all. Pocatello, another day in the mid-90s. We'll start off with plenty of sunshine, but then late afternoon into the evening, we could see rain showers and thunderstorms, so don't be surprised. It'll start off nice. You'll wash that car, and sure enough, it'll try to rain later in the day, right? Southeast Idaho Chevy Dealer 7-day forecast. The chances of showers and thunderstorms will take us through the weekend. And then not much of a cooling trend, but at least we'll spend a day or two in the upper 80s. And then back in the 80s or back in the 90s by next Thursday. Idaho Falls 7-day forecast. Chances of showers and thunderstorms late in the day tomorrow through the weekend. And then we got 80s. Well into the work week, so still quite warm, but taking a little bit of the edge off the heat. Teton area 7-day forecast. There's a chance of showers and thunderstorms Friday through the weekend into Monday. And a couple of days next week, it will be in those comfortable 70s for the central mountains. No comfortable 70s, but we will see highs down into the 80s starting Sunday